So, this was my first time modeling a character. I was still watching a tutorial. It took me like a whole weekend to do it. It was a 3 hours long tutorial. And this was after I stopped watching tutorial. Now you are going to tell me, yeah, but there is a gap between these two models. And the answer is yes. There is a 1 year gap between these two. But this one, on the other hand, was just 2 months after I made my first try. And this time it was on my own without any tutorial. And these two other models were made the same year. So I followed a really simple technique, something that anybody can replicate to be able to do this on my own without watching any tutorial. And I'm going to share it with you. What you need to know is that when you're starting Blender for the first time, you have to watch a tutorial to get you at least familiar with the few basic skills like how to navigate inside the viewport or how to do some basic transforms like rotating, scaling, I don't know, moving objects. Those simple things that are really complicated for a beginner. You need somebody to take you by the hand and show you, walk you through it. Because Blender is overwhelming when you first open it. There are so many menus, so many things you can do, so many tabs. So you really, the first time I downloaded it, I quit. I just uninstalled it and said, this is not for me. There's too much things. I can't learn it. So that's why at the beginning, you need somebody to take you by the hand and show you. But after that, once you're done learning the basics, you need to know, you need to define to yourself what exactly do you want to do with Blender. You need to find exactly what makes you start using Blender. Why are you using Blender? For some people, it's for animation. Some other is for character modeling, or I don't know, VFX, or yeah, there are so many things you can do with Blender. So at that moment, once you've learned some basic skills, define exactly what you want to do, because this is really important for what's to come. Because if you don't know exactly what you're going to do from the beginning, your energy is going to be spread on many tutorials that exist on this on YouTube, for example. You will find some really interesting tutorials about VFX. I'm not interested in VFX, but some tutorials are just so well made that you want to try it. And if that's not what made you start Blender in the first place, you're just going to drift away and start doing things that were not even interesting for you in the beginning. You'll have problems doing it. You'll end up frustrated and you'll want to stop Blender. So at the beginning, just define exactly what you want to do. For example, for me, it was character modeling. I wanted to make characters. I wanted to model them, then rig them, then animate them. So from the beginning, I was like, okay, this is what I want to do. So I'm going to only focus on watching tutorials about character modeling, how to create characters, how to rig them, even though I hate rigging, and how to animate them. So for a whole year, that was the only thing I was interested in. I did not watch tutorials about VFX or how to model houses or I don't know any other stuff. So I was only focusing on that subject. That what it really made me improve super quick. Okay, so you found the right subject you want to follow. It's for example hard surface modeling, and you found the right YouTubers that have the resources you want to get. Have the knowledge they want to, and they are willing to share it with you, and you start following the tutorials. What you need to know right at that moment is that what you need as a beginner or intermediate is the workflow, his workflow. You need to know how he goes from zero to the final result. What's in between? How does he do it? And the first tutorials, you need to focus on that, on establishing the relationship between every steps he does and how he does it. Now, once you've understood his workflow, you might start feel confident and thinking that you can do it on your own. But the truth is you can't. Unless you have like a really good memory and you can remember every step he went through and you can do it on your own, that's possible. And if you're like me and you don't have a good memory, I have a really simple tip for you. don't follow blindly the tutorial. Don't just be there replicating exactly every step the guy is taking. And at the end, you just end up with the same exact product, but not the knowledge. You don't know how to go from the default cup to the final product. You don't know what goes in between because you don't have that. You did not memorize it. But the thing is, it's actually really simple to memorize it. Just take a piece of paper and a pen and write it down. Take your time, write it like you are in school. Take notes, make notes, write down the whole process, document it, and keep it somewhere. It's really important, guys. You don't know how powerful that technique is. And I used it for everything I learned with Blender. I have documented it. And that's why now I don't even need to look at the documents anymore or the papers. I wrote it. Then I started doing it, forcing myself to do it without watching tutorials. And then at some point, with time, it starts to become normal to me. So I went to watch tutorials about character modeling. And I wrote down every single step. I made it as detailed as possible so I would not need to come back to the tutorials. So I picked up all the techniques they had. Everything they shared with me, I stole it. I kept it and I made it my own. Now it's mine. Right? And I use it. And I don't even need to read it anymore because it's mine. It's mine. Right? And that's what the mentality you need to have. When you're watching a tutorial, don't just follow blindly. Okay, he does A. Okay, I'll do A, B, then B, step 3, step 10. No, at the end of the, let's say he deletes the video from the internet. You can't do it anymore because you don't have the knowledge now. You have the final product, but you don't know how to do it yourself. That's why it's really important. It's not only about Blender. It's about learning anything. Anything you want to learn in life from internet. You have to document it. Right? And trust me, it's really, really, really a really simple trick. A really simple thing to do, but so powerful. When you come back to your documents, it's yours. It's your writing, your informations. You don't have to watch a tutorial. So it makes the learning process so much easier because when you are writing it, you're memorizing it at the same time. Now, there are some people who have like a really good memory and they don't need to do it. Fine. Not everybody has that. If you are that kind of person, great. You're gifted. I'm not. I don't have that good memory. So I write down and it helps me achieve things I couldn't achieve without writing it down. So in like 2 months, I improved like a lot, right? And in 1 year, I went from this to this. It's completely crazy. Now I can make models in like 1 day, just an afternoon, without watching the tutorials because I documented it. So document everything you're watching. Document the tutorials, steal the techniques. Everyone who posts a YouTube video knows they are sharing it with the whole world. So they're ready to share with you their knowledge. So don't be shy. Take it, make it your own, steal it, write it down somewhere and use it. Okay, so you've documented the tutorial, you've got the paper. You're now free to try it on your own. Go and chase your dreams. The reality is your first project will most likely be a failure. You'll fail. And you talk, it's okay, right? And you might even at some point need to go back to the video and watch it. It happened to me. You can do it, right? The only thing you need to worry about is not spend, again, all your time watching the tutorial from scratch. Like, some parts might not be clear enough or not easy to write down. So you might have to go take a look again. It's okay. But just still have your notes right at you. Watch the tutorial, close it, and keep working. Okay, so from what I've say so far, you might think that you don't need, at some point, when you get really good, you don't need tutorials anymore. And it's false. I still watch tutorials. Even people way better than me, the best people using Blender I know still watch tutorials. The thing is, you can't know everything about Blender. That's just as I was saying at the beginning. There are so many things to know. You can't have all the expertise that exists. let's say somebody who specializes in modeling, I don't know, houses, needs to add a feature to one of his house. Like he wants to, when you open the door, a light turns on, and he realizes he needs a driver to do that. But he's not a specialist in drivers. So guess what? He's going to watch a tutorial about drivers. And yeah, there you go. You have to watch tutorials at some point. And that's normal. But this time, document it, write it down. So next time you need to use to open a window and turn a light on, you already know how to set up a driver. Still the techniques. Okay, I'll finish this video with one advice. The most important thing about this whole process is to have fun doing it, right? It's you really need to be having fun learning new things to enjoy this process, because if you treat it like schoolwork, you're not gonna make it. You end up frustrated and drop out. But it's not a contest. It's not like a race, or you don't have to be better than everyone. You don't have to know everything. And it's okay to fail your first projects when you're trying on your own, right? It's part of the process. It's really not something that should be competing with your personal life. Like, don't stay up all night on a project, or don't feel too frustrated because you're blocked somewhere. Trust me, it's not worth it. Close your PC and go outside. When you come back, you'll have fresh eyes, and you'll find better solutions. So okay, just remember to have fun, and it's going to be all right. From what I've said so far, I might sound like I'm inviting people to stop watching tutorials while I myself am making tutorials. Don't get me wrong, guys, you can still watch the tutorials and enjoy them, right? But just take notes, and yeah, after you've taken notes, go practice. You need to practice a lot. You need to really be applying what you just stole. So when you steal a car, you want to drive it, right? This is okay, don't follow the last advices. I guess I'm going to cut the video here, and see you next time. Bye. Take care.